Hello, welcome to another episode of the Machine Learning Essentials series. I'm Nishan Tucker, and in this video, we'll talk about openness and interoperability for machine learning environments. As we've discussed before, machine learning as a workload has evolved and matured on the back of many open source contributions from various communities, organizations, and projects. As a result, there is an inherent bias to keep machine learning open to the latest innovation from these contributions and interoperable with various best-in-class products or services. This is not only a requirement by practitioners, but also by organizations as they look to inspire and reap the benefits of open source and avoid any kind of vendor lock-ins. Let's see how Azure lives up to the promise of openness and interoperability for the machine learning workload. We look at it from the perspective of choice of tools and languages, interoperability with popular libraries and frameworks, contributing back and driving innovation within open source, and ecosystem support. Let's dive in. First, the choice of tools and languages. Data scientists and developers are very opinionated about their choice of tools, whether it is the interactive notebooks like Jupyter or the feature-rich IDEs like VS Code. In addition to that, the everlasting debate on the best language for machine learning, some prefer Python and others look at R. Azure Machine Learning isn't opinionated at all about any of these. It provides SDKs for both Python and R that can be integrated into any tool that supports executing the languages, whether it is Jupyter and other REPL environments, or IDEs like Visual Studio Code, PyCharm, Rstudio, etc. It also has an option for command line interfaces for those in love with the command line. Let's take a look at VS Code, Jupyter, and Rstudio, as Azure Machine Learning has invested in deeper integrations, including widgets, etc. Visual Studio Code supports working with notebooks as well as through Python code files natively. You can either use the Azure Machine Learning extension within VS Code, which then allows you to securely utilize the Azure Machine Learning compute instance as its execution environment. Or you can start within the Azure Machine Learning Studio and open your notebooks with the VS Code option. Alongside its native integration with GitHub and Azure DevOps, it offers a very productive environment for data scientists. Here's a pro tip. If you work mostly with desktop tools, try out the newly improved integration with VS Code to securely access compute resources like compute instance without the need to enable SSH. Your IT team will be thankful. Next, let's talk about Jupyter Lab and Jupyter Notebooks. Jupyter is an open source project that lets you easily combine markdown text and executable Python source code on one canvas called a notebook. Just like with VS Code, Azure Machine Learning Compute Instance also comes pre-installed with Jupyter and Jupyter Lab, which enables data scientists to author, train, and deploy models in a fully integrated notebook experience in the machine learning workspace. On similar lines, Azure Machine Learning resources work with R to provide a scalable environment for training and deploying a model. The Rstudio Server open source edition is configured and installed on the Azure Machine Learning compute instance for R users to get started quickly and build models faster. But tools are just one piece of the puzzle. For data science teams to be truly productive, they need the latest data processing and machine learning frameworks and libraries. These comprise a wide-ranging list that includes PyTorch, TensorFlow, Scikit-learn, alongside Pandas, Qualas, and many more. So how does Azure Machine Learning enable data scientists to be productive with all these frameworks? Well, for starters, all of the Azure Machine Learning's compute options come pre-installed with many of these frameworks and libraries and optimize them to run at scale. Additionally, to make data scientists more productive while building models, Azure provides two options for their dev test environments. The first, the Azure Machine Learning Compute Instance, which provides an integrated workstation for data scientists to leverage with all the Azure Machine Learning tools. It comes with a latest set of PyPI, Conda, Deep Learning, and Onyx packages pre-installed so that data scientists don't have to worry about looking for these or any version conflicts and can be productive from day one. And then the second, which is the data science virtual machines, or DSVM. This is what a data scientist would gravitate to if they need even more flexibility on operating systems, hardware environments, and compute engines installed. These come in both Windows and Linux version and allow users to log in via RDP or SSH. Just like Compute Instance, these also come pre-installed with the latest frameworks and libraries. But that's not all. These even come with developer tools, databases, Docker, and compute engines like Apache Spark or Apache Drill. This makes the Dsvm an optimal dev workstation for data scientists to log into. Depending on the need and flexibility, data scientists can choose the environment that best suits them. Here's a pro tip. Using the Azure Machine Learning Compute Instance allows you to share your notebooks with other users within the workspace. This enables effective collaboration within a team of data scientists. Well, we saw how Azure Machine Learning brings the best of open source to data scientists and makes them more productive. Now let's see how Microsoft is also a good citizen of the open source community and how it leads and contributes back to it effectively. Microsoft leads many open source projects in the community, like Onyx, including the Onyx runtime for model portability across frameworks and accelerated inferencing. PyTorch, in collaboration with Facebook, MLflow alongside Databricks, and many more. Microsoft has also open sourced all its responsible machine learning toolkits for the community to utilize and further contribute. Toolkits like InterpretML for model interpretability, FairLearn for model fairness, and error analysis to understand model errors and debugging. It also open sourced a differential privacy toolkit called Smart Noise, which was built in collaboration with Harvard Labs to advance data privacy within machine learning. These are just a few examples of how Microsoft is a good Samaritan in the OSS world specific to machine learning. Now, we've talked about open source tools, frameworks, and contributions, but it is also as important to understand how Azure Machine Learning interacts with other services within Azure so that users can build end-to-end solutions instead of piecemeal projects. Azure Machine Learning powers the machine learning capabilities within Synapse and Power BI to offer data engineers and analysts the ability to build models within their tools of choice. Additionally, Azure Machine Learning also integrates the compute resources of Synapse, Databricks, and HD Insight alongside the Azure Kubernetes Service to offer flexible compute options to run your training jobs. For security, governance, and monitoring, Azure Machine Learning utilizes all of Azure's offerings like Azure Active Directory, Key Vault, Private Link, App Insights, and Azure Monitor. Here's a pro tip. Utilize the Advanced Machine Learning Quick Start template to deploy a secure machine learning environment even for dev test workloads. And for core services like databases, storage, and orchestration, Azure Machine Learning surfaces Azure SQL Database, Postgres, MySQL, alongside Azure Blob Storage and Data Lake Storage, and Azure Data Factory. These integrations show the richness of the ecosystem that Azure Machine Learning supports for various aspects of the enterprise machine learning pipeline. Now, that was a very quick tour of how Azure Machine Learning offers an open and interoperable environment for everything an enterprise may need to build scalable, innovative machine learning solutions. To summarize, in this video, we looked at choice of tools and languages from notebooks to IDEs and Python to R, interoperability with popular libraries and frameworks within data scientist workstations like Compute Instance or Dsvm, contributing back and driving innovation within open source with projects like Onyx, PyTorch, responsible ML toolkits, etc., and the ecosystem support to cater to the entire lifecycle and not just a small part of it. Well, that's it for this video. As always, to try out these capabilities on Azure, please spin up a free Azure Machine Learning workspace at aka.ms/aml-trial and download the 30-day learning journey from the Data Scientist Resources page at aka.ms/data-scientists. See you in another episode of the Machine Learning Essentials series.